this session and we're in the drop zone. We need a quick lap or that's qualifying over for us.
Today on the shores of the Red Sea in the Lower Hejaz Mountains to visit one of the newest circuits on the Formula One calendar. We're in Jeddah, home to what we all hope is going to be a thrilling Saudi Arabian Grand Prix. So let's take a look at the topographical map of the Jeddah Street Circuit. As you can see, a number of challenging corners for the drivers to master here. We'll see just how much the teams have benefited from their time spent in practice this weekend. And like many street circuits, this track has the potential to punish drivers that get it wrong. Let's hope we avoid any safety cars today. It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. World champion Max Verstappen starts from pole position, edging out Sergio Perez, who lines up P2. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Sainz, Hamilton, Russell, Fernando Alonso, Bottas, Joe, Tsunoda, Gasly, Leclerc, Moore, Stroll, Norris, Magnussen, Hülkenberg, Ocon, Albon, Oscar Piastri and Logan Sargeant. Which of these talented drivers will come out on top today? Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into turn one, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It will keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
Bright is good, gearbox is responding normally. Make sure to warm up the tyres and brakes. Warm the tyres and brakes throughout the lap, please. Superb parking there, mate. Let's make sure we get the edge on the surrounding drivers as the lights go out. Mm-hmm. and move forward. Tire condition for now, everything's looking good. Race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
And that brings the Saudi Arabian Grand Prix to a close as we reflect on the team's impressive performance today. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
Here come today's winners. The team at Red Bull have done a phenomenal job recently, and it's clear to see that they've put in the work, and they should be so proud of the victory they've secured here. Their rivals have made up some solid ground today. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Max Verstappen seemed to just effortlessly weave through the other drivers today without a care in the world. He was definitely my driver of choice.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. And pulling further ahead in the standings, it's Red Bull. Another team that will be satisfied with this Grand Prix is Alfa Romeo, whose good result moves them further up the championship. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action, and I can't wait to see what's next.
We had a major issue on the production line earlier this week, so the entire development package for the weekend has failed. Any redevelopments will need to be ordered from the R&D screen. I know we were expecting some new developments to come through, but some of them have failed quality control. We'll need it, thanks. I know these kinds of decisions can be challenging, but I think you made the right call.